Apple currently dominates the tablet market. For every 100 tablets sold, 27 of them are iPads. But Apple didn't invent the tablet, or did it? So credit for coining the term tablet goes to Moses, who ascended Mount Sinai to receive the Ten Commandments. Wait, we're talking about tablet computers. Never mind, let me go back. At least a little credit goes to Sir Arthur Charles Clarke. He's the guy who wrote the book that became Stanley Kubrick's film 2001: A Space Odyssey, and in chapter 9 of his book, he described something called a newspad that got electronic updates from the world's newspapers every hour. It sounds a lot like a tablet, doesn't it?
The 9000 series is the most reliable computer ever made.
But let's get real. Several companies in the 1990s and early 2000s experimented with rudimentary tablets, including Microsoft, Atari, and even Apple itself with the ill-fated Newton. And some people might even say that Palm Pilots are tablets, but those people are wrong. The problem with early attempts at tablets is that the technology just wasn't ready yet. What we know is a tablet now needs two things: a really good touchscreen and very tiny, powerful components to fit between your hands and the screen and power the whole thing. And what was the first company to come to market with a device that had both? Apple, with the iPad in 2010.
This is what it looks like.
Was the idea really original? No, but did Apple do it better than everybody else did to that point? Yeah, totally. And that's what Apple's really good at, finding some idea that's floating around there and packaging in a way that makes it a huge consumer hit and selling millions of them. That's why it has enough money to buy every major professional sports team in the US. The tablet market isn't doing so hot lately, but Apple's not giving up on it yet. It just introduced the iPad Pro. It's a 12.9-inch device, it's huge, it's meant for graphic artists and illustrators and designers, and it kind of resembles a laptop, especially given that it's got this keyboard case, and it's a pretty powerful machine. So we're getting to this point where tablets look like laptops and laptops look like tablets, and the future of mobile computing is looking like a pretty interesting place.